networking architectures, what protocol required, then the layers, layered architecture, and then the OSC layer. My voice is okay, na? Okay, right. Okay.
Okay, sir. Voice okay.
Yes, yes, right. Huh? So we were discussing about the different networking concepts. Yeah. That at all a protocol architecture is required, and then we went at the OSI layer model, and then encapsulation and caps. Okay, these things we were just seeing. It's what we saw, isn't it? So to make the complex networks simpler, we need these protocols, protocol architecture. And for simplifying this design, again, this OSI model has been TCP/IP, later on came TCP/IP, and TCP/IP model also. Why encapsulation? If you want to include our in higher level objects, for that this encapsulation is required while designing the modular network.
इसे क्या वाइस से डिफरेंट ये तकलीफ हो रही आवाज ये किसका माइक म्यूट कर दीजिए अजय कुमार प्लीज
सो And because the changing of the physical moving connections, instead of doing it physically, I think it is difficult to. Please mute your mics here, all of you. Who is the standby? So basically, for that we use abstraction. So we can do it logically, we can link them and quote them. For that flexibility, for having that networking flexibility, go for this network abstract. Then we talked about the different types of international organizations that define these data networking structures and protocols and universally followed. Then its origin and all that, when it started 1947 and all that. जब हम लोगों को ये वो the freedom at the time itself this ISO was also formed it seems. Okay. ISO is not a model. It's a OSI is a model. It's not a protocol. And all these things also. Why? What is the OSI model and what? Why it? All things we discovered means we discussed before starting of the class. Now let us come to the different layers. There are very good YouTube links I have posted in the PowerPoint. Sometime when you get some time, you can go through this the PowerPoint. I think it, but to play videos, I think we don't get that much of time. If we have some time in the end, we will see. There's a YouTube, excellent YouTube videos are there, particularly in networking. You have lots of videos. Just you should have the thirst to enhance your knowledge. And right from what is MAC address, what is ARP, what is DHCP, and all these things you will find. Anybody want to tell something? So, normally this OSI layer, it is of the 7 layers. Okay, it starts with the, you can see it in any way, starting from layer 1 to 7 or 7. If you see from 1 to 7, then it is the hardware say software key over. You see from 7 to 1, it is from the software to hardware, because these are the two important parts. And data packet frame and bit, as our one of our friends was telling, different exchange units, they are all data, frame, packet frame and unit. Who was telling that? I think sometime back, OSA layer ka jab aaya tha, tabhi unhone bola tha. Anyway. So, we'll be seeing one by one. Okay. So basically, 1994, ISO developed this OSA layer architecture with 7 layers, and it is having a specific processing function. Okay. Each layer is having a specific processing function. How to connect, that's what is basically. You know, open systems means systems that are open for transfer of data. Those systems and how they are interconnected. So, nothing much complex. A layer has been followed actually across the globe. So this is called an N plus one entity, N plus one layer entity. Yeah, one layer entity, it ensures that the lower layers only as a service provider. This diagram is dikhaya hai. Ki jo lower layers hai, jo N plus one layer, na, higher layer, it will just indicate the delivery. It will treat the lower layers as the service provider. Okay. And N plus one layer is a peer protocol. N layer peer protocol. So suppose this N plus one layer is requesting delivery, then the service provider indicates delivery and then it is exchanged using N layer protocol. Just for a guidance it is given. Just so you understand it. So to remember mnemonically, these layers, agar aapko yaad rakhna hai easily, then mnemonics have been devised there. Na, mnemonic, you know mnemonics, na? Mnemonics are quite popular in microprocessor and all this. Na? Microprocessor programming over during his college days or something like that. Any idea what is a mnemonic? Any mnemonic means M-N-E-M-O-N-I-C, mnemonic. No. Normally, this microprocessor, 8085, which we learnt in college days and all that. This mnemonics are very common. Mnemonic means an easy word to remember. It may be short sentence and all that. Ek chota sa vakya ho sakta hai, yani to ek वर्ड हो सकता है ना, जिससे आपको याद रखना होगा. यहाँ ऊपर लिखा हुआ है जैसे, लेट मी मेक इट फुल स्क्रीन अदरवाइज. सो यहाँ ऊपर लिखा हुआ है दिस, ऑल पीपल सीम टू नियर डोमिनो पिज्जा. व्हाट इज दिस एक्चुअली? ना, सारे लोग जो है डोमिनो पिज्जा के पास जा रहे हैं सर. एंड Others, please do not touch Steve's pet alligator. That's the over. So, iska kya matlab kya hai? Iska OSA layer se kya matlab hai? So, analogy, as one of our friends, it is the analogy. Yes, you are right. Analogy to connect ourselves with some other thing actually. Yes, easy to remember, memorize. Hai na? Memorize karne ke liye aasani. See, the 7 layers can be remembered like this. If you remember, all people seem to near Domino Pizza. You will remember that A stands for application, P stands for presentation, S stands for T stands for transport, N stands for network, Domino stands for data link, and the pizza stands for the physical layer. And aap usko ulta dekhenge, jaise you move from the hardware software side, then it will be, please do not touch Steve's pet alligator sort of thing. And a P is for physical data layer like that. It's just a mnemonic to remember the order. It's just layers 1 and 1 to 7 have been written in that way, in such a way. So just for your remembrance I have given. Then if you see the upper 3 layers, they are software, application layer, presentation and session, that is for the software. And the transport layer is the main heart of the OSA. This is the layer ka model, OSA model ka heart hai. And the last 3 layers are the layer 1, 2 and 3, that is the hardware layer. Okay, then now if you see how the data flows application layer, you can see that the application layer is responsible for providing networking services to user. And there are certain ports kept reserved for सर्टन एप्लीकेशन सर्टन सर्विसेज एप्लीकेशन लेयर में जो सर्विसेज है उसके लिए एक एक कुछ कुछ पोर्ट्स जो है रिजर्व रखा हुआ है. या प्लीज डोंट टेक सेल्स पर्सन एडवाइस ऑल्सो दैट इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट. यस दैट इज दिस इज अप टू यू एक्चुअली. मेमोनिक्स ऐसा चीज है जो याद रख के लोग आईएएस क्लियर कर लेते हैं. मैं सुना हूँ कि पीपल बिकम इवन आईएएस ऑफिसर्स इफ यू हैव मोर मेमोनिक्स ऑफ ऐसा मतलब माना जाता है. इट्स इजी टू रिमेंबर एक्चुअली. यू हैव टू जस्ट डीकोड. वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट एनकोडिंग डीकोडिंग एंड ऑल दैट. सो देर आर सम पीपल नॉट रीड दैट बट देर आर सम पीपल इट इज सेड दैट दे कैन रिमेंबर बुक कंप्लीट पूरा बुक को याद रख सकते हैं. हैविंग रिमेंबर्ड सम मेमोनिक्स दे आर एबल टू रिमेंबर द होल बुक रिकलेक्ट द होल बुक. जैसे ये फील्ड है ना हम लोगों का जो टीचिंग फील्ड वगैरह में देर आर सर्टन प्रोफेसर्स हु कैन रीड होल बुक बाय रिमेंबरिंग सम मेमोनिक्स. कुछ सेंटेंसेस जो है वो कुछ पैराग्राफ्स वगैरह लिखते हैं तो पूरा डिकोड होकर पूरा का पूरा बुक का कंटेंट उनका मेमोरी में आ जाता है ना समथिंग लाइक दैट. Yes, providing network service to user. Yes, so that is what is done. So identification of services is done using port numbers, and certain port numbers are kept reserved for certain services like HTTP and hypertext transfer, FTP file transfer protocol, SMTP, simple mail transfer protocol, Telnet, TFTP, and a text file transfer protocol, and all these they have been allotted port. And they are standard actually HTTP 80, FTP 21, SMTP 25, okay, Telnet 23, TFTP 16. ऐसे port numbers जो है करके रखा है. And the application layer is all data only. Okay. Then ports are nothing but socket. Socket भी बोला जाता है. Socket है that is entry and exit point to the layer. And port can be anything between 0 to 65535. Okay. And out of this, actually, the reserved ports are 0, 1, 0, 2, 3, and the open ports are 1024 to 6553. And 6553 ports are open ports. Okay. Now we see this. This is also known as a desktop layer, and identification is done using port numbers. You have seen that entry. Layer and this we have seen just okay. That is actually open ports are 65535. There in the earlier side it was wrong actually. 5555 actually one five is missing. So this is how our reset website reset.ac. So this is the application layer. Then suppose the TP. Yeah, Ajay Kumar wants to ask anything. If you want to ask anything, you can just raise hand. Otherwise also you can just unmute your mic. If nobody is there, then you can unmute. No, pardon? Okay. Ajay? So this is how a client and a web communicating. So the HTTP request is sent, and okay, this is how it goes: client to web server. HTTP request on port 80. करके वो बोल रहा है ना. HTTP is reserved on port 80. That's why yes, 80. You are right. Balakrishnan is right. So HTTP reply sending reply on. So it goes actually. Okay. Then similarly for FTP. Suppose file transfer protocol request, then it will go and FTP will appear on 21. So as soon as it appears on port 21, then it will take it as FTP. Okay. So means it will understand that a file has transferred and protocol. So we saw that these are the numbers kept reserved, and this is how it works in the application layer. Then next. So the presentation layer. Okay. So the presentation layer is basically for converting data into standard formats. The data to mil gaya hai. Kahan se entry hona hai? Kahan se hona hai? It has been defined. But now if you want to convert into some standard format, then that is under this presentation layer. And the standard most standard formats are perform encoding and decoding. Yes, the encryption, decryption, compression, decompression. Yes, Kavita Meena, yes, decompression of data. Yes, we will see that. So this ASCII code, EBCDIC, JPEG, MPEG, BMP, MIDI, and all these are the different types of data formats. Okay, WAV, MP. They are all in the presentation layer. So all these things, as our Kavita is saying, is encoding, decoding, encryption, decryption, and decryption of data, and all this is done on the presentation layer. It is also all about data. And if you see, the next layer is the session layer, which is responsible for terminating a session. Na ek session ko स्टार्ट करने में और बंद करने में भी ये सेशन लेयर काम आता है. जो सेशन आईडी वर्क सेट. ओके, एग्जांपल्स एग्जांपल यस आरपीसी रिमोट प्रोसीजर कॉल, देन क्यूएल स्ट्रक्चर्ड क्वेरी लैंग्वेज, एनएफएस नेटवर्क फाइल सिस्टम. दिस आर ऑल द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ द सेशन लेयर. ओके, सेशन लेयर प्रोटोकॉल्स. देन all about, and then the comes the, what is this, this is called the heart, and main pura OSA layer structure ka heart hai. And this is the following transport layer carries out the identifying service, multiplexing, demultiplexing, segmentation, and then the sequencing and reassembling, all these things we are done there. Transport layer, they are done in the transport layer. Transport layer. That's why it is called heart of the OSI model. And layer number 4. We have layer 3 switches. The layer 4 here. Okay. And as we heard this, the same thing. The different functions are done in the transport layer. So note and all that. You see the TCP UDP, there are two different protocols. One is the transmission control protocol, oh, and another is the user data gun protocol. One is the and another is the connectionless acknowledgement. No, you can just distinguish between the two types of protocols, TCP and UDP. TCP is comparatively lower, UDP is faster, and port numbers are 6 and 17. One is for 6 and 17. And the protocols are HTTP, FTP, SMTP. Isme hota hai. So DHCP protocols are used in UDP, user datagram protocol. So the transport layer, actually this TCP 6 and UDP 17. That's what is shown in this. Earlier I'm looking at this port number 6 and port number 17. For that only it has been shown here. CP6, UDP17. So far, so good. It's all about. Yeah. And one header bit, transport header. Okay. Once this transport header has been added, now it is being called segment. Now called segment. And. And now on the transport header, and then the another, this along transport header, now it is, if it is having the network header also, then in the network layer it's being called packet. So what is the difference? You can just understand, as one of our friend was saying, packet. Okay, so network layer is all about router, because this last three layers we were talking about hardware. Then you will have basically data com and router, the switch, and now the modems. Okay, hubs. Okay, hub modems, LAN extenders, else the different hardware components of your network. So the router is the main which works at the main equipment, work network layer, and handles packets. So network layer is all about the logical addressing, and its functions given routing and path selection, It routes packets according to unique network device address and it provides flow and congestion control. Yes, there are functions. Okay. Basically, also responsible for the delivery of individual packets from source host to destination host. Source host to destination host tak le jaane ka kaam bhi ye karta hai. So it selects the best path to data. That's why it's routing. Okay. Yes, routing. So routing is again divided into two types of calls. One is routed protocol, and another is the routing protocols. Yes, interconnectivity. Yes. Yeah. Then we have routed protocols. We IPX, Internet Protocol, and in the routing protocols we have RIP, that is Routing Initiation Protocol, IRP, and OSPF, which is very popular. All our networks mostly working on this OSPF, na? Open shortest path first, then IGRP, that's called. That is also again gated routing protocol, na? GRP stands for gated routing protocol, I think. EIGRP, EIGRP, anyone? What is EIGRP? You people are layer switch. There is a layer 2 switch. BGP, yes. BGP is also a border gating protocol, na? Border router gating protocol. Router to Prisma CD. Okay. So EIGRP, what is EIGRP? I was just asking.
Exterior
internet gating routing protocol. Yes. Enhanced interior gateway routing protocol. It's not exterior thing.
Enhanced
routing. Well, these are all different names of the protocols. But how do you ensure all this when you buy routers? Aap log test kar paate hain using this protocols and all. I don't know actually. How do you ensure? Because you are all SSEs, commands where you are using commands and testing that. Right, but whenever you my SSC in charge. So it's what actually, so this is what is being shown, how it gets routed, na, in this drawing, how it gets routed. It's what being shown. So you can see just the data, how is it getting routed, shown here. Suppose so okay, I said data. This is asking www.edset.ac.in. It's searching for the path. So sabse pehle ek router ke paas gaya and just selected the path and gone. Reached. And go alternate path also. So all alternate paths also it will keep checking. That's what. Okay. If one whichever is the easiest path, it will follow that path. Test path. Normally shortest path is followed if it is OSPF protocol. So it is segment and then network header and packet and then the router and then the data link layer. So data link layer, it is having two sub layers. One is the LLC and another is the MAC address and a MAC. Well, just have in your mobiles also the MAC address. MAC address hota hai na aapka mobile mein. So check your MAC address. Have you checked your address? Yes, IMEA address, but MAC address is also available for your connectivity, na? Wi-Fi connectivity. So physical address, you will find that it is 48 bit. Aapka settings mein jaake check kar lijiye, mil jayega na MAC address also. So in the data link layer having, oh yes, bit address, yes, you are right. Or it will have a 12 digit hex number also, hex decimal number, and all WAN protocols. Okay, LLC having all WAN protocols like PPP and HDLC, point to point protocol. This is, I think, high data link or data layer control relay. Okay, all these things will be coming. whereas this MAC address is responsible for error detection. Device working on data link layer is, we have devices, that is switches, bridges, your NIC network interface card, and all this will be coming under data link layer. They will be all working in this as per this link model of OSI model. So this is what, again, once again, you can see it's how the data is getting converted. So this data link head, you know, header and the terminal bits, I think, yeah, they have been added. Then it is being called the frame. So data segment packet to frame. So here the switch is taking control of it, and that has been defined. So what are the functions that are being carried out in a data link layer? So is access, physical addressing, and also network topology. So it takes care of these three main functions of flow control, error control, access control. Okay. Controls. Okay, these are all very important. Data link layer is responsible for moving frames from hop to hop, node to node, and frames को hop to hop या node to node और उसको कैसे delivery करना है, ये सब जो है define करता है ना. Procedure for operate communication links also. Okay. So this is how it is, the data link layer is having the main five functions, and five functions. It gives service to upper level, is the network layer जो उसके ऊपर है, और नीचे जो physical layer है वहाँ से services receive करेगा. And the main functions are packetizing, flow control, and then react control, addressing, and error control. ये पांच functions perform करता है. Same thing has been shown in this drawing also. Five functions that are performed by data link layer. Piece of layer. Okay. So finally, we have come to the physical layer. So the data, the segment, the packet, the frame, and then when you come to the physical layer, it's all bit. And once, and here comes your hub, or even can be directly your port itself. Na? Port in the switch itself is capable. So the physical characteristics of interfaces and medium, that are all dealt in this physical layer, and of course bits, and rate, transmission rate. What is the difference between router and L3 switch? Okay, we will see that router and L3 switch. Actually, the difference is very marginal. Very marginal difference. We will see that also. What is the difference between router and layer 3 switch? Both are working in the layer 3 only. Both are working in the layer 3. The protocols used are different. Okay. And we will see that both are having ports also, WAN ports also are available. Layer switch. But I think LAN ports are more in layer 3 switch. Let me confirm you. I will confirm you tomorrow. Okay. It's good that you have asked Anil Kumar. Yes. So in the physical layer, the synchronization of bits, the line configuration, physical topology, transmission modes, all these, they are taken care in the physical layer. And actually the bit-to-bit binary transmission is done in the physical layer. So this data encapsulation and decapsulation. Your voice is low once again. Why is becoming low?
Okay, sir.
Low ho gaya hai voice.
Nahi sir. ठीक है,
ठीक है सर. ठीक है. वो कहीं कहीं लो हो सकता है यार, पूरा इंडिया में एक जैसा नहीं है प्रॉब्लम. ओके, दिस इज हाउ द डाटा फ्लोस. एक्चुअली एनकैप्सुलेशन एंड डीकैप्सुलेशन, इफ यू सी, जस्ट एज वी सॉ दैट ऑल पीपल सीम टू नियर डोमिनो पिज्जा, एंड प्लीज डू दिस पेटल सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग, दैट सेम थिंग हैज बीन शोन हियर, हाउ इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड फ्रॉम डाटा, डाटा टू segment, segment to packet, packet to frame, and again bits and bits to again back. That's what is being shown here. So encryption and I mean encapsulation, decapsulation is done. Yes, okay. That's what is shown. Okay. So basically the electrical, the physical connectivity, you know, responsible for electrical, mechanical and procedural checks. So all these are physical layer. Data is converted in binary, that is zeros and ones, and in the form of electrical pulses suitable for transmission in either coaxial or twisted pair cable or light. Then the devices are, as you know, they are all hubs, repeaters, cables, modems, and they all come under physical layer. So the same has been shown here. Jaise matlab ek ek header add hote gaya hai, originally the message has been received by the in the application layer, and then as the headers go, then finally again the same thing has been shown in a block diagram, and headers getting dropped one after the other, and
excuse
the
me,
application
sir. Excuse me sir,
it's a note to the oh the message is sent. Yes, right, yes, yes, boliye.
Hubs dikha raha hai ki physical layer mein hai, jabki hub jo hai frame transfer karta hai.
Hub jo hai obsolete ho gaya na,
nahi frame transfer karta hai na sir, to net tool hona chahiye. अब जो है नॉन इंटेलिजेंस डिवाइस है बट ट्रांसफर करता है फ्रेम. अब हब सर
पता नहीं एक्चुअली दिस एक्चुअली दैट्स करेक्ट एक्चुअली जो है ना दिस मॉडल दैट्स व्हाई इन बिगिनिंग एक मॉडल है ना. सो डिफरेंट मैन्युफैक्चरर्स विल बी अगेन फॉलोइंग डिफरेंट मॉडल्स अपना अपना प्रोडक्ट्स को ये करने के लिए. दिस इज अ वेरी बिग मार्केट एक्चुअली लीडिंग मार्केट इन द वर्ल्ड इज IT, है ना. वन इज द IT एंड द सेकंड इज द फार्मा. दो ही मार्केट है जिसके वजह से दुनिया पूरा है ना. सो इफ यू सी दे विल बी डिफरेंट, इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट एक्चुअली टू से. इवन सी द स्विचेस आर अवेलेबल इन डाटा लिंक लेयर, नेटवर्क लेयर, है ना. द रूट अवेलेबल ओवरलैप होता रहता है. जैसे वन ऑफ आवर फ्रेंड वॉज आस्किंग व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन L2 L3 स्विच एंड रूटर. And so all actually it's a model, itself model, it's not a strict thing. So if you find that when you go to this TCP/IP, they have gone for integration. We will see that also. Yes. Now overlap hota hai, physical layer mein bhi dikhate hain, kabhi dikhate hain. So it was all about evolution. Jaise jaise evolve hote gaya hai, to waise waise jo hai wo, it's not a very concrete model nahi hai. OSI model actually manufacturers, they are not following also. ना वो लोग फॉलो भी नहीं कर रहे हैं अभी बहुत से लोग.
सर
इट बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट कि एग्जैक्टली इसी लेयर में ये आएगा करके. जस्ट अ टेंटेटिव मॉडल गिवन. ओके
सर.
यस बोलिए. हां हां
टेलीकॉम मैनुअल में
हां जी
ऑनलाइन आईपी में जो है आईपी में हब को आईपी में रखा हुआ है जबकि बोलता है कि नॉन इंटेलिजेंट डिवाइस.
हां जी हां जी
लेकिन वो आईपी में रखे हुए हैं हब.
तो नॉन इंटेलिजेंट डिवाइसेस ही है ना. हब इज आल्सो नॉन इंटेलिजेंट. फिजिकल लेयर में जो है सब नॉन इंटेलिजेंट ही है. सो इट ऑल डिपेंड्स एक्चुअली, है ना. एग्जैक्टली उसी लेयर में जैसे आप देखेंगे और इंटीग्रेट हो जाएगा. देयर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन द फिजिकल एंड डाटा लिंक लेयर आल्सो, है ना. ऊपर के सॉफ्टवेयर लेयर भी चारों को मर्ज कर दिया. दे आर हैविंग ओनली फोर लेयर्स इन TCP/IP, है ना. So basically you cannot say that इसको इसी में रखना है करके नहीं है, है ना. So it's not very concrete model नहीं है ये. It's all more about software and all designs. अगर आप design करते हैं hardware, then it's nothing like that. And one day actually we may already I don't know, it might have come also. You might have done away with all this model also. वैसे निकल है जो है, they will not follow this model. They will follow their own model also. It's all open ended. And software is all open ended. You cannot say this is just a model that has been in use. Na wo kai saalon se isko use kiya hua hai, but somebody they want to maintain their specific identity in the market, then again they set up some overlapping models also, na, where two layers get integrated and all this. So this is how the same thing actually has been shown, how is transferred between the nodes. नीचे जो है हार्डवेयर लेयर्स हैं, ऊपर सॉफ्टवेयर का जो है इंटीग्रेटेड दिखाया हुआ, सोर्स पीसी टू डेस्टिनेशन पीसी. डिफरेंट एप्लीकेशंस, इफ यू सी द कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशंस, नेटवर्क एप्लीकेशंस एंड द इंटरनेटवर्क और इंटरनेट एप्लीकेशंस, That you will have this MS Office and the animations, these are computer applications. And the network applications, you will have this email, file transfer, client server processor, network management, and network applications. And in the internet work applications, you have this www and the internet browsers, then conferences, just have audio, video, and data. Internet work applications can extend beyond the enterprises. Now we are having this enterprise edition, WebEx. So again, as I'm all asking, so here this fellow, this TCP IP layer, if you see, they have integrated. ये जो है सॉफ्टवेयर का तीनों को दे आर कॉलिंग इट ओनली एज एप्लीकेशन एंड ओनली हार्ट आउटपुट लेयर एंड द नेटवर्क इज कॉलिंग इट एज द इंटरनेट एंड हियर एज यू वर सेइंग दैट हब इट इज बीन इंटीग्रेटेड नाउ द नेटवर्क एक्सेस लेयर इज बीइंग कॉल्ड नेटवर्क एक्सेस लेयर टीसीपी आईपी यू हैव ओनली फोर लेयर्स है ना चार लेयर है ऐसे इसने इंटीग्रेट कर दिया इसको सो इफ यू सी द कॉन्सेप्ट TCP, you can just see this drawing. How logical connections are being provided. है ना इतना layer के बदले में या जैसे यहाँ पे application, presentation, session, ये तीनों को है ना applications are able to handle all the things. The applications, the software applications, they are able to handle all the things. So the application X to application X and application Y to way, both they have all been integrated. Using logical connections, logical connections use karke, that is what is this transmission control protocol. Similarly, the next one is below the transmission control protocol, you have this IP, that is having a global network address. IP address is a global network address. We have two versions, IPv4, IPv6. Okay. IPv6 is more popular nowadays. So there has been migration going on since years from IPv4 to IPv6 and all this. Okay, so below transport layer, that is handling IP, and it's all based on IP. And below that is the network access protocol, and then the physical, actually. Okay, so if you see the technically, the TCP and IP are two distinct protocols. Saying they are two distinct protocols and they are so commonly being used, that's why we call them as TCP IP, but TCP is for the software part, and four that is being handled by the internet protocol. The layer three that is being handled by the internet protocol, and TCP corresponds to the transport layer in OSI. So this is how it is. Comparison, if you compare the different suits, the protocol suits also have been given. The application layer is having MTP. Okay, if it is TCP is being followed in the transport layer, and DNS, domain name server, RIP. What is RIP? आजकल व्हाट्सएप में बहुत रिप रिप मारते हैं, अगर कोई एक्सपायर होता है तो इट्स नॉट दैट रिप मारते रहता है ना, कोई एक्सपायर हो जाता है तो आजकल व्हाट इज दिस रिप आर आई कॉल एनीवन लोग सब गूगल एक्सपर्ट्स हैं, आप लोग सब गूगल करके सब बता देते हैं.
रेस्ट इन पीस.
हाँ जी, रेस्ट इन पीस नहीं यार. रोटर इंटरनेट प्रोटोकॉल है ना, दैट्स व्हाई. इसलिए मुझे मालूम था कि आप कोई बोल देंगे रेस्ट इन पीस करके, इसलिए मैं बोल रहा था कि जो मारते हैं व्हाट्सएप में कोई रिप मारते हैं, तो वो वाला रिप नहीं है. ये वाला रिप जो है, इट इज अबाउट द रूटर इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोटोकॉल, रूटर इनिशिएशन प्रोटोकॉल ऑल्सो समटाइम्स इट्स कॉल्ड, रूटर इनिशिएशन प्रोटोकॉल भी बोलते हैं. सिंपल नेटवर्क मैनेजमेंट प्रोटोकॉल एंड इट्स डेफिनेटली नॉट रेस्ट इन पीस. ओके, so to be on the lighter side of it, rest in peace nahi hai wo. So similar, this next is corresponding to the transport layer in the TCP IP. This is again TCP and UDP are used. Okay, And here we jo na, it is here you will find this ARP, IGMP, ICMP, ye sare protocols aayenge IP mein, hai na, internet layer in that internet layer or in the TCP IP mein internet layer jo layer 3 jo hai OSI model layer mein, to uska corresponding hai internet layer. And this IP is having different types of protocol like IGMP, IGMP, ARP, address resolution protocol and all this, okay. And corresponding to the last two layers of your hardware, data link and physical, the network layer, it's called NIC, you know, network interface layer, and it is having this Ethernet, token ring, frame relay, ATM. ATM kya hai? Again, similarly, abbreviations are so rampant in this IT field, so confusion both ho jata hai, hai na? Itne sare abbreviations rahenge aapko, ki usko karte karte ATM log nikal wala nahi hai definitely. Yes, asynchronous transport is not an automatic teller machine, nahi hai ye jisme se paisa nikalta hai wo nahi hai, kahi ye protocol seekh le paisa aa jayega aisa kuch nahi. Okay, so TCP is a suite for internet, so it can be used to communicate across any set of internet. It is more popular because it is more compatible. LAN WAN compatibility is very very high, that's why this TCP IP suite for internet is quite popular. And the very popular application like again terminal emulation and FTP may file transfer and all these specifications are included as common applications. So you have been seeing this different, so remote login is also possible na kahin dur se bhi आप लॉग इन करके यू कैन मैनेज योर नेटवर्क, यू कैन मॉनिटर नेटवर्क, ओके दैट्स व्हाई दिस एसएनएमपी इज देयर, सिंपल नेटवर्क मैनेजमेंट प्रोटोकॉल. एंड नेम मैनेजमेंट इज आल्सो देयर, है ना, नाम जो है उसको आप यू कैन डू, सो हैवंट यू गिवन, अभी जैसे वेबएक्स में भी यू आर गिवन योर ओन नेम्स फॉर योर दिस थिंग ना, रोल नंबर एंड नेम, ऑल सिमिलर टू दैट यू कैन गिव ऑल नेम्स, डोमेन नेम्स आर possible. Actually it becomes very remember, human memory is very limited for numbers, numbers yaad rakhna mushkil ho jata hai jabki naam yaad rakhna aasan hota hai, isliye so we need this and all so, this is for our convenience rather than for the convenience of PCs and all this. So some similarities are also there between TCP IP and OSI. That you will find that both are a layered architecture and both provide some functionalities which are quite similar, and they are both protocol stack and reference model. All the similarities between and differences, if you see there are many differences, like usme 7 layer hai, isme 4 hai. Protocols are replaceable in OSI layer, it's not to replace protocol in TCP IP. Then protocol fitting is there, and here protocols does not fit. Okay, so all these differences you just go through. That's a approach, an horizontal approach. One is connection oriented and also connectionless. Here it is only connectionless service. And okay, there are some differences, you can just go through them. OSI is a generic and protocol dependent standard, whereas TCP IP is standard protocol around which the internet has developed. Okay, because of this communication protocol of TCP/IP. Then OSI model defines services, interfaces, and protocols very clearly and makes explicit and protocol independent. That's why it is called protocol independent. Whereas in TCP/IP, interfaces and protocols are not clearly stated. One of our friends, they were asking that have been 1 and 2 router in a switch in 3, 2 and 3, all these things. It's because the TCP/IP interfaces and protocols are not clearly separated. It is protocol dependent. That's why it is like that. Okay. In concepts, basic concepts central to TCP/IP model are the service, interface, and protocols. Based on this. Three concepts, it has been designed. So you can just go through this. So many YouTube videos are also there to enhance your knowledge. You please see these YouTube. So I have changed. If I am not given, I will give the full PowerPoint of this. So we'll focus more on this IP addressing. So IP addressing is all about in this layer 3 logical address, and we have two types, V4 and V6, now version 4 and 6. What was the necessity to go for IPv6 and that too 128 bit addressing? Because the requirement of IP addresses has been growing. IP V4 say V6 mein jaane ka main karan hi the bandwidth. IP addresses are not bandwidth is okay, that is one thing, but IP addresses long back actually we are not using much IP addresses. Sara devices jo hai abhi tak hum log network kiye hi nahi hai. If you go on seeing the demand, IP address will skyrocket actually. Aapka ek ek aadmi ke liye, every person may be needing some hundreds of IP addresses when we go into the fully networked world. Hum log aage jayenge and such new applications like Internet of Things, Artificial Intelligence, ye sara jaise launch ho jayega, then each individual on earth, maybe they may need something like 100 IP addresses or even more than that. Har ek aadmi ko 1000 IP address chahiye hoga. So that is what is going to be the world in future. Duniya mein aake IP address zarurat padega. Because all your devices, everything will be networked. Just imagine, agar aapka ghar mein jitna hai, aapka car hoga, wo bhi sabka IP address rahega. Network, kuch network ho jayega. So the demand for IP addresses is growing day by day. That's why we had to go for IPv6. And having requirement long back, IPv6 migration has been class long. Okay, even Railway Board also has given instructions. Sometime I believe at least some 5 years back itself, 4 years itself for migration to IPv6. But still we are comfortable. We don't need much, I think. We are not fully networked organization. That's why it's going on. So address is a unique global address for a network interface. Yes, let network address in IPv4, you are right. That is the main reason. Ranjan is saying less network IPs. So we are comfortable still. Abhi bhi kuch itna kuch dikkat nahi hai. So it's a unique global address for a network interface and 32-bit long identity. So network devices, they need this IP address. Encodes a network number actually. It's a network prefix. It is in two parts. So what is DHCP and all this, you just see the videos, it will be helpful to you afterwards. So dynamic host configuration protocol, okay. No, able to play this. Just let me try.
Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to Circles.
Are you able to see the video?
Yes.
No, that's what actually see even.
Okay, so first off, some points on DHCP. HCP stands for that. Its goal is to assign unique IP addresses to our host. It also provides other network addresses such as the DNS rate and the DS address. It comes in two flavors, as a client and as a server. Here's our network, two PCs, a switch, and a router. For our computers to work over the network, they need an IP address. That address has to be unique on the network. Otherwise, data goes to host A when it should actually be going to B. It is an on thing become mess. Could assign these addresses manually. We only have two PCs, so it wouldn't be a problem. Imagine if you had 200 PCs. Yeah. Don't want to be doing DHCP sort this out. Each computer will run a DHCP client. This will allow the computer to ask for an IP address from an a DHCP server. This is where the IP addresses are managed. DHCP servers can be ran on routers or servers. It's like into your router, but in an enterprise network, it's likely handled by a server.
You're not getting voice, eh? Turn your PC on,
if it doesn't have an address, it looks.
Voice is my problem.
Too low. You just say, I wanted to test whether it's working or not. Okay. It's, but the voice is lower. Okay. Getting, but voice is low. Only video is coming. Okay. See, actually, that way, otherwise, also the voice is a bit low. So basically, he's trying to explain the dynamic host configuration protocols, how the hosts and their dynamic, how it is dynamically allowed. Port addresses and all that, that is being explained in that video. Share. Yeah, already that links have been shared. Links have been saying share. But the voice is low, they are saying. That's why I just stopped. Anyway, we are left with another 5 minutes, I think.
This is a broadcast message. Devices get this message, get it. This is step one. Step two, DHCP offer. When the DHCP server gets the message, it says, cool boy, got some IP addresses. This one. It then sends the offer to the host. So it's given, the host will choose the first one it receives. Step three, host says, awesome. I'll take it and send the request to the DHCP server. DHCP sends the IP address to the host along with the subnet mask, the default DNS. The DHCP server keeps a record of all the leased IP addresses and their leased times. When the DHCP server on a, it gives it a lease time. The lease time is a time period where the host will need to renew its address that we all take for granted. If one day DHCP just got up and left, well, we'd be pretty okay. So first off, some points on DHCP. DHCP for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. Its goal is to assign unique IP addresses to our hosts. It also provides work as the subnet mask, the default gateway, and the DNS address. It comes in two flavors. It comes as a client and as a server. Right, let's see an example. Here's our network. We have two PCs, a switch, and a router. For our computers to work over the network, they need IP address. Not just any IP address. That address has to be unique on the network. Otherwise, data goes to host A when it should be going to B. Host A doesn't know what the f*** is going on, and the whole thing becomes a mess. We could assign these addresses manually. You see, it wouldn't be hard. It wouldn't be a big problem. But imagine if you had 200 plus PCs. Yeah, we really don't do it. So how does DHCP sort this out? Each computer will run a DHCP client, and this will allow the computer to address. Somewhere on the network, there will be a DHCP server. This is where the IP addresses are managed. DHCP servers can be ran on or servers. At home, it's likely built into your router, but in an enterprise network, it's likely handled by a server. So when you turn your PC on, if it doesn't have an address, it looks for a DHCP server. It just shouts out to everyone, hoping somewhere on the network there is a DHCP server. This is a broad message. All of the other devices get this message, look at it, and drop it. This is step one, called DHCP Discover. Two, DHCP Offer. When the DHCP server gets the message, it says, cool, bro, I've got some IP addresses. How about this one? It then offers. If more than one offer is given, the host will choose the first one it receives. Step three, DHCP request. And sends the request to the DHCP server. Step four, DHCP ignore. The DHCP sends the IP address to the host along with the subnet mask, the default gateway, and the DNS server. DHCP server keeps a record of all the leased IP addresses and their leased times. When the DHCP server gives out an address, it gives it a leased time. The leased time is a time period where the host will need to renew its address, otherwise it will return back to the available pool of addresses ready to be pushed out of the host. This stops IP addresses being wasted anytime you throw a computer out or just unplug it. Okay, how do you know? The most important thing to remember here is this is a general overview of how DHCP works. Different vendors and different DHCP settings and can change these specifics, but the overall concept remains the same. So the four steps. DHCP Discover looks for DHCP Offer. The DHCP server offers an address to the host. DHCP Request. Host request delete that address. DHCP Acknowledgement. The DHCP server sends the IP address to the host. DHCP uses UDP ports. The client will use port 68 and the server will use port 67. Again, life without DHCP isn't worth thinking about. Pretty much everyone uses it every single day without giving it a second thought. If you like this video and make sure to let us know by giving us a thumbs up, commenting, and subscribing. We're not mind readers, so let us know. That's it for DHCP. Thank you for watching.
Million.
हेलो अभी है अभी अभी मेरा वॉइस आ रहा है कि नहीं? हेलो
आ रहा सर।
हेलो यस ओके राइट इट्स टी टाइम ओके वी विल सी ओके वी विल सी टुमारो वी आर हैविंग 4 आवर्स डे आफ्टर टुमारो 2 मोर आवर्स ओके we will be covering TA2 and TA3. I just wanted to tell you that at around 16:30 there is a special class on tunnel communication. All of you can join. Join if 16:45 or you can ask permission from your instructor whosoever is taking the class and join at 16:30. Okay, 16:30 or 16:45 as per your convenience. This class on tunnel communication. Okay, right. Thank you all. Viva questions. Okay. We will have discussion once tomorrow and then we will share it. Okay. Right. Thank you.
Thank you,
आज लास्ट क्लास नहीं है आपके लिए तो इफ एनीबॉडी इंटरेस्टेड यू कैन जॉइन टनल कम्युनिकेशन एट 16:30 थ्रू द लिंक व्हिच इज शेयर्ड इन योर व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप టనల్ కమ్యూనికేషన్ లింక్ షేర్ చేశారు సార్ వాళ్ళ గ్రూప్ లో
తర్వాత ఇది యాప్ ఇది మొబైల్ లో వస్తుందా అదా మొబైల్ యాప్
ఇంకా చేంజెస్ చేయాలంటే సార్
మొబైల్ కంపాటిబిలిటీ ఉందే ఒకటి మొబైల్ ఏదో వస్తుంది వెబ్ పేజ్ వస్తుంది కానీ చాలా ఓపెన్ అవుతుంది
అది మొన్న ఏదో చేంజెస్ చేశారు తర్వాత రావట్లేదండి
మొబైల్ యాప్ అన్ని ఇప్పుడు గూగుల్ వరకు వస్తుంది చెప్పారు
అది యాక్చువల్గా డెవలపర్ త్రీ ఫోర్ డేస్ లేదు ఏమవుతుంది
అన్ని బేసిక్స్
చెప్తారు